coming up on this week's news. An out-of-this-world career is on offer after a UK college unveils a course for electricians in the space industry. A top battery expert warns that we urgently need to educate everyone about the dangers of lithium cells, and a British father and son are electrocuted by a broken cable. Welcome to Electrical News Weekly in association with Solar Trade Sales, your easy one-stop shop for all things solar. Whether you're listening in the van, on site, or down at the wholesale counter, I'm Joe Robinson, and I've been through the best of the electrical industry news to save you the trouble. And if you think you've spotted the two words that I've been challenged to slip into this week's show, comment with them below for the chance to win a prize. An opportunity to take your career into orbit is on offer after a Scottish college unveiled the UK's first course for electricians in the space industry. Fife College says its groundbreaking course will prepare sparks to take up opportunities working with rockets and satellites. Run by the University of Edinburgh and Fife College, the course is funded by the UK Space Agency with up to 25 places available. The six-week-long courses will be taught online and in person. Course leaders say they are specifically keen to recruit women who've taken a career break. Christina Termain of the University of Edinburgh says that the courses have been created to ensure that participants will be readily employable in the space sector upon completion. I've popped the link to the programme in the show notes if you want to become a part of the constellation of students on the course. In other news, one of the UK's top battery experts is calling for the new government to implement an urgent media campaign warning people of the hazards of lithium cells. He wants it to be like the Green Cross Code ads of the 1970s. Paul Christensen, founding director of the Lithium Ion Safety Consultancy, took to social media to raise the alarm. He says the primary responsibility of any government is to keep its citizens safe. He wants the public educated about how to use and dispose of lithium cells safely. Christensen says he's actually a big fan of the battery technology and believes they're essential to cutting carbon emissions. He points out that the lack of understanding of lithium batteries has killed men, women and children in the UK. There is a lithium battery fire every single day which ruins lives. He's also calling for a comprehensive recycling industry that's ready and willing to deal safely with all sizes of lithium batteries from mobile phones to electric vehicles. You can follow Christensen and his campaign on LinkedIn. I've popped a link to that in the show notes. Meanwhile, in Brazil, a British father and his son have died after being electrocuted by a broken cable. The pair were found on a coastal trail in Ubatuba between a pair of popular beaches. Local media reported that their corpses had burns consistent with receiving a powerful electric shock. The father had one end of a broken mains power cable trapped underneath his leg. Police investigating the case have registered the deaths as accidental. Electro, the utility company providing power to the area, expressed its condolences and said it would work with the local authorities on the investigation into their deaths. The Deputy Secretary of the Tourism Department, Rodrigo Andrade, told the press that the incident occurred in an area not regulated for ecotourism. He described the path on which the pair were found as an old access route used by local residents and not one open to ecotourism activities. He said he would like to reiterate the importance of hiring a licensed agency and qualified tour guides who can perform this activity with professionalism and competence, ensuring the safety of people on the trails. The Foreign and Commonwealth Development Office confirmed that it is working with investigating officers in Brazil. Meanwhile, in Mexico, a tourist has died after he was electrocuted in a hot tub. Jorge Guillen from Texas in the USA was killed and his wife Lizette injured after an electric discharge in a jacuzzi at the Sonoran Sea Resort in Puerto Peñasco. An eyewitness said bystanders made frantic attempts to pull the couple out of the water but were prevented by the electrical current. One woman even received a shock herself as she tried to enter the hot tub. When authorities arrived at the complex, Guillen was found submerged under the water. The resort has reportedly shut down all the hot tubs in the complex pending an investigation. One of the UK's biggest house rewires has just been completed. That's because the house in question is none other than Buckingham Palace. The six-year project saw 190 miles of ageing electrical cable replaced at the royal household. That's around the distance from London to Leeds. To replace the dangerous wiring, no fewer than 40,000 floorboards were individually taken up and marked with a number, with each detail recorded in an intricate map. When the wiring was replaced, each floorboard was put back in its original place like a giant jigsaw. Nothing worse than rewiring an occupied home. You can just imagine the king, can't you? "Yes, any chance we could keep the Wi-Fi on?" Some 41 apprentices assisted the electricians and others on the renovations. The rewire was part of a wider refurbishment of Buck House, which cost £369 million. Hopefully, some of those sparks were rocking up in Lamborghinis by the end of the job. In product news, Signify, the world's biggest lighting company, formerly known as Philips, has unveiled a new brand that's designed for electricians. The over-the-counter trade range is named EcoLink. Signify says it's developed in the UK to meet the specific needs of electrical professionals. It's promising competitively priced luminaires such as LED panels, IP65 rated floodlights, battens, emergency bulkheads and non-corrosive fittings. They're available in-store and online from distributors. Martindale has upgraded its safe isolation and voltage tester kits this week. The company has introduced the SRD range of its proving units, which feature a stepped voltage output matched to two-pole tester thresholds. The new SRD unit will replace the current models. It also has the ability to deliver either AC or DC with a simple push button. Safe isolation procedures require voltage indicators to be proved against a known source both before and after use. The company is also shipping its latest industrial socket tester, the CP range. It's designed to provide a quick and reliable way of confirming 16 and 32 amp sockets are wired correctly. The unit features three brightly illuminated LEDs and an on-tester lookup chart. A British firm has launched an emergency exit sign with a housing made of wood. Philip Payne says that 30% less carbon dioxide was emitted while making the Arden compared to a standard model. The firm says the wooden sign is crafted from European joinery-grade oak, sourced from responsibly managed forests. It is glow-wire tested to 850 degrees C and meets all relevant fire-resistance standards. Now, what's being billed as the UK's lightest podium has been unveiled by Wernico. The Boss QuickPod weighs just 28 kilos and has been designed to be easy to fold and close for easy transporting. It features a self-closing gate and guardrail, as well as double-braked wheels for extra safety. The podium is aimed at tasks like installing multiple downlights in ceilings. Lastly, a reminder that we're in the market for your stories, your projects and your recommendations, as we'd like to share them with the wider eFIXX community. In July, we're shifting our focus to data and networking and fire and security, plus all the new innovations that are coming into the industry. Send us pictures of your installs or let us know if you've come across any new kit that's making your job easier. Now, just before we get to your favourite bit of the show, where I reveal last week's challenge words and winners, we want to thank our premium partners. We couldn't make the news without you. First up, they're the brand that pride themselves on keeping people close to what's important with the world's most recognisable doorbell chime, its Ring. Up next, for all your circuit protection needs, they're like having an Italian star striker in your Premiership team, it's Ludum Palazzoli. And do you want a no-fuss lighting solution that's packed with value? Then try the EcoLink range from Signify, combining value for money with top-end Signify quality. Now, a business that will literally bend over backwards to give you first-class service on the trade-only supply of signal reception and distribution, custom install, home automation and security products for all residential and commercial projects, it's All Trade. If you want to pump up the jam and join the home heating revolution, then it's got to be heat pumps from Daikin. Are you looking for easy-to-install modular lighting solutions and emergency lighting products designed by specialists in the industry? They're ready and waiting to light up your life. It's Cosnic. The best thing to come out of Yorkshire since stainless steel, the home of EV Ultra and other groundbreaking and quality products, it's Doncaster Cables. And with an incredible range of equipment from EV charge points through industrial sockets and switches to kit for explosive areas, plus they supplied gear for a Campari factory, so they'll always have a place in my heart, it's Scarmy. Big thanks to you all, we really appreciate your ongoing support for the news. If you think you know the words that I've smuggled into this week's show, pop your guess into the comments. We'll take all those correct guesses and select one at random to be the winner of an eFIXX goodie bag prize. Answers submitted after about lunchtime on the Thursday after release will not be entered into the draw. Now let's reveal the winners of last week's challenge word competition. The words were mulch and renaissance, and the first person to get both right was Martin E63. Well done to you. Make sure you click the link in the show notes to claim your prize. Thanks for listening to this episode of Electrical News Weekly in association with Solar Trade Sales, your easy one-stop shop for all things solar. Make sure you subscribe to receive the next update. Thanks for listening, and until next time, have a great week. Stay safe out there, and remember, there's no such thing as a torque-calibrated arm.